Okay, new little review on my newest 8x54 sporting rifle here. And I already got a shooting video up. That's the last video I did, I think. And I'll just go over some of the things about it. This one here was built by LCN Company, which I have no idea who the hell they were. They're probably sort of like a company that was just set up to do conversions, and then they just sort of went away after they all, after it was done. It was either they were the importer that had them done or something, but it's hard to say. I've tried to find information on them and I couldn't find anything, but so anyway, we'll start from the beginning here, I guess. So this thing started out as an M96 Swedish Mauser rifle, and it was built in 1911, Carl Gustavs. And so then I guess by the 50s or whenever, it was either surplused out or sold to these companies. Like there was Vap and DePot and Fallon, which some of the other ones I have, who did the conversions on those, and they did a lot of these guns. They converted them into sporters, and there was several different grades of how much modification they did to the gun, made it. The cheaper ones would be more like this one, where they didn't do much to them, left them the barrels alone, so they have very little metal work to them. And so you can see, like I mentioned in the other video, this thing retains the 29-inch barrel. And so basically all they really did to it, they bent the bolt on it. These were straight, starting originally. So 5-shot mag, they left the thing for the empty mag, you can't close it. They did modify the front of the mag, it appears, because of the going from 6.5-55 to 8mm, that the front of the case, front of the, you know, the neck is bigger, so they have even more room up here. And they left the triggers the same. The stock, like everything matches on the serial numbers. So they basically took the gun all apart, sporterized, stuck back together with the same parts. They didn't mix them up or anything. So they retained the old military butt plate. They just slimmed the military stock down on the wrist here, thinned this a bit. They left the old military swivel that was here, but they made it narrower. So they just took the old ring out and shortened it and pressed it back in. As you can see, it takes the narrow kind of European sling instead of the original ones were like an inch wide. You can get like a more of an American style kind of sling into it. There's checkering here, but that looks like somebody that owned it did that because it's really rudimentary. They got these raised panels when they were thinning, carving the stock down on both sides, which are kind of nice. They left the crest marks and the old serial numbers on the side. They thinned the wood here. It still retains the old military back sight. It starts at 300 meters as low as it goes. And there's a blob of silver solder or something here, so you can't stand the sight up anymore. I don't know who did that. I don't know if the guy, whoever owned it, or the people that converted it did it. But you can see it still has the ladder in here, but the little V in the ladder, when you did stand it up, has been filed away anyway, so you wouldn't be able to use it anyway. But you can still go up to 600 meters. I'm not sure why you'd want to, but if you wanted to, you could. And they cut the stock off here at the barrel step, and they move the nose cap back and put the spring on it to hold it. And the barrel step, they had to cut the nose cap so it would sit up over the step in the barrel here. And they put the other sling swivel through the cross hole that's on the front nose cap here, which I think it was for some sort of monopod or some sort of attachment the Swedish military had. And it's narrow like the other one. And as I mentioned, the 29-inch barrel, it has the original style military base on it. When I got it, it had a like a bead sort of front sight, but it was looks like it was made out of the old original military blade. But when I was shooting it at 100 yards, I guess I said it in the other video too, but it was shooting like 13 inches high at 100 yards. And but that would sort of correspond with a 300 meter battle sight. So I put this sight on it instead. This is off like a Bren gun or something like that, but it's considerably higher than the old sight, so hopefully that will bring it down to some sort of reasonable reasonable at the point of impact at 100 yards anyway. But and that's 8x54. The barrel matches, the serial numbers match the receiver and everything, so they just took the old barrel off and bored it out 8mm, and that was a pretty good conversion. I guess they sold these, you get them in 6.5, like the Vapen to Potten ones anyway, and or you could pay a little extra and they would bore it out for you. And it's a good conversion, because if the 6.5 barrel was a little bit rusted out or shot out or pitted or whatever, then you could just bore it out 8mm, and that would get rid of all the rust and everything like that, or any of the anything that's wrong with the bore anyway, and you basically have a new barrel. And did give them a little bit better for heavy game in Sweden in the old days. The 196 grain, I guess at Norma loaded, going 2290, like almost 2300, would be considerably better than the 6.5 round would have been. But I got some pictures, I'll put them after this video, that show the Vapen to Potten ones. They're like four different grades of ones that they sold. And I got another picture that shows some of the Norma loadings at 8x54 or something. It shows, I think they had a couple that were 190 something, and one was like 159 grain or something like that. But I'll post that if you're interested. And other than that, it's not a bad gun. The barrel's a little bit long, but it's hopefully it'll be good if I gotta try some loads with some slower rifle powder, and hopefully the long barrel might really get some pretty good velocities out of it. So you don't want to get to dry the pressure up too much with fast powders, because of the action. Like, the thing's 99 years old. So, but so anyway, that's the end of the video. And don't forget to click the ads; it'd be greatly appreciated. And we'll see you later.